Welcome to the SWN Podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. Yes, even though I said the last episode was going to be on the 14th with Mickey Vago, I've squeezed in an extra into the season. I am joined for this very special edition. It's not going to be a big full length, all the dinosaurs and all the sheep and cow patter. I've squeezed in an extra episode with Irn Dru Marshall. Welcome to the show.
Cheers, thank you very much for having me, mate. It's been a long time.
It's been a long time coming. I was having a look, because I know that you're the first interview that I've ever did for our
That's right.
Facebook page, and that, and it was March 2014 that it was.
Wow. So that's 10 years, mate.
10
10 years.
years. In a month's time,
Wow.
will be 10 years since we had a very, well, for me, anyway, it was a very awkward chat because I've never done that before, and you were the
Well,
first one.
we need to start somewhere, don't we?
Exactly. And then from that point onwards, here we are. This will be episode 251 of the podcast. And
Wow.
we've done about 300 odd podcasts and interviews and, oh God, all those things. So it's your fault for anyone
Aye,
that's
so
been
my
to
fault, mate.
it's
Blame
Drew
me.
Marshall. So we've got you on the show today. It's a very quick episode. We're not going to do the usual get diving into your backstory, because I think we've got about 15-ish years worth to go through. So we won't do that.
Aye.
Because we're talking about one particular thing, which will be, I've got all noted in front of me, so I don't get it wrong. So World Association Wrestling South Africa, Wrestle Monster 6 is the main thing that we're going to be touching on today, where
Yep.
you match with Mr. Wrestling on March 29th.
Yes.
So for
I'm
those,
buzzing.
listen, for those that are listening and somehow are listening in South Africa, it's at the Splash Festival at Nelson Mandela Bay in South Africa. Never thought I'd be in a podcast advertising stuff that's happening in South Africa, where it's going to be South Africa versus Britain. And you've been chosen to represent the British side of things to face Mr. Wrestling for the WAW SA Championship.
That's right. That's
That's.
right. Not only representing Britain, but representing Scotland. I'm the only person that's going to be on this tour that's representing Scotland, and I think I'm led to believe I'm actually going to be the first ever Scottish wrestler to wrestle in South Africa.
I did my research, and from what I can tell, you're the second. But
Second.
it's still good company, because in the 1980s, there's a video on YouTube. Could have been South Africa, might not have been. There was a match with Drew McDonald in
Ah,
the
well, good.
80s.
Aye, there's a good chance he was in South Africa in the 80s, because I do know that a lot of the lads, shall we say, for the old school British era, they did do a several amount of tours over there in South Africa. But we can go as far as saying I'm the most modern day
Yeah,
Scottish wrestler. So aye.
we'll go with that. But even then, still, if it's 1-1-2 and the first one's Drew McDonald, I think that's not a bad company to be in
Oh,
when it
of
comes
course,
to it.
that's. Of course, you know what I mean? Well, the man's a legend. You know what I mean? RIP to the man. I learned a lot from Drew when I was younger. I had the privilege to get to meet him when I was 13, 14, you know what I mean? But yeah, it's a privilege.
That's it. I mean, you've been around, I don't say like you're at an old man here, but you've been around for a while. When we interviewed you 10 years ago, it was, I think you're 15. I think you started your training right about then.
So I started training when I was 13, just turned 13. Back in 2000 and I want to say 2005. So it'll be 19 years this year that I've been involved in Scottish wrestling in general. So
And
19 years.
you've, I mean, I've got just a quick look, brief look through your back catalogue. This is just relying on cage match, which, you know, could be hit or miss. But to see some of the opponents that you've come up against during that time, whether it's in Scotland, whether it's part of WAW, to now be 19 years in, going all the way to South Africa. I don't know how far you've travelled for your wrestling before, whether you've flown the international seas, but is this the furthest you've had to go so far? Do
No,
some wrestling?
South Africa, hands down, South Africa is going to be the furthest. The only other places that I've been internationally, I made my international debut last year in Sweden, in Malmo for SWS during the summer there. So that was my first ever like long distance like international booking. You know what I mean? But like, I mean, in fact, in terms of travel, like when I started coming down to Norwich in 2013, And still to this day, I'll get the coach down here, the Megabus or the National Express. Now, I don't understand National Express's logic, because for some reason, the same with Megabus as well, they like to go cross-country all the way, start to Glasgow, they bounce all the way to the sides, then they get to London. So then I need to wait in London and get a bus from London to Norwich. Now, one day, so for me to go Glasgow to Norwich is 16 hours. To come home is another 16 hours on a coach. You know what I mean? So, I mean, as far as travelling, I've done my fair bit of travelling, but going as far as other countries, this will be the biggest one.
And it's Mr. Wrestling, who had a quick look at, you know, brother, he looks pretty familiar when it comes to it, but he seems to be quite a big hit in South Africa, and he's got that WAW
yes.
Championship. So as far as big opponents go, not just reputation-wise, but physically-wise, he's got to be up there as probably one of the most physically impressive opponents that you're
definitely 100%. I mean, you just look at the guy, and like, obviously for the people that are listening, the man looks like the love child of Hulk Hogan and Macho Man Randy Savage, is the best way of describing this. But to take nothing away from the man, his popularity in South Africa is up there with the worldwide population of Hulk Hogan. The man is a legit star. You know what I mean? The man's, he's on your game shows at night, your talk show hosts, your morning, afternoon stuff. He's on everything. Everywhere you look in South Africa, that man is in your face. You know what I mean? And I know that, like, away from wrestling, he's an advocate for anti-bullying. And he travels all around South Africa and does these demonstrations to try and help people to prevent people from bullying. You know what I mean? So he shows them different aspects of life and things like that. So I do know he does a lot of stuff involved in charity. But when it comes to wrestling, again, he's wrestled some of the biggest names in South Africa. But I don't think he's ever came across somebody like myself before. And that's not me sitting here trying to be big-headed or trying to make out that I'm something that other people aren't. You know, there's different styles of wrestling there. I'd like to think that I'm quite privileged that I've been trained in several different backgrounds in wrestling. You know what I mean? And in the past 5 years, I'd like to think that I haven't exactly perfected my craft, but you still, because obviously you learn every day, but I like to think that I've clicked. I understand how it works. Do you know what I mean? So when it comes to people like Mr. Wrestling, I very, very intimidating. Look at the size of the man. Just look at him. He's got a presence, you know? Like, the only person that I could think of that I've ever worked in the ring that would even come close to the comparison would be the Canadian wrestler known as Brody Steele. Who, again, he's about 6'4". Very, very intimidating looking man. You know what I mean? But I'm looking forward to it, because I think I'm going to learn. You know what I mean? You always learn in this business.
I mean, just looking at your last year or so with that match with Mr. Wrestling, of course, WAW and Championship Pro Wrestling merged to form WAW SA. That was in November. That's right. So that's a fairly recent merger to have. Between that... So that's them expanding, and you're very heavily involved with WAW. You're right. Also quite heavily involved in W3L as well. Yes. And they've teamed up with Progress. So they're right. On Demand Progress. So
yep.
As far as being in the business for 19 years, this last year or so, it seems to have afforded extra opportunities to see Irn Dru Marshall internationally.
100% agree, be there.
Yeah, so how do you feel about things like that? I mean, WAW, of course, you've had recent matches right about the same time with Gangrel and Scotty Duhati. Is, are you now, like, right. Say, last 5 years, you've found it click. Have you just, that now, just, you're finding all these opportunities just presenting themselves to you, and you're just kind of just lapping everyone that you can get?
In a way, you could say that. But at the same time, now, like, I find myself saying this quite a lot to either, whether it be up-and-coming trainees or people who are starting to establish a name for themselves in the circuit. But what I give all my credit to working on the holiday parks, the camps. You know what I mean? So whether that be Pontins, Haven, Butland, Parkdean Resorts. I genuinely, and this is me, this is probably the only time you'll ever hear me being a wee bit above myself, but I genuinely thought I was one of the best wrestlers ever produced in Scotland. And I'm going to go back and say, let's just say it was like 2013, 2014. I thought I had everything. I thought I was the mutts nuts. I thought I was untouchable. Nobody could do the stuff I was doing. But then I get brought in with WAW and we started doing the camp seasons and the camp runs. And very, very quickly did I learn. I knew nothing. I wasn't what I thought I was. I didn't have the education or the experience that I thought that I had. So coming down to Norwich and then obviously doing all the circuit runs, you're working with many, many people, like many different people. Like I've worked with guys from South Africa, from Canada, Mexico, Italy, like all over the world. I've wrestled guys in the camps. So you're always learning different styles. But for me, you learn on the camps much more because 9 times out of 10, the people that are coming to watch you, they're not your casual wrestling fans. You know, I mean, they might have watched it once or twice on the TV, or their kids may have never been interested. But then when they come along to watch your show, it's your job to educate them people, to make them believe in your story. You know what I mean? It's you find how to react to a crowd. If you're doing a certain style and the crowd aren't taking to it, then it gets to a point where you gain enough experience that you're able to switch, literally just switch the match round to a different style. Whether it be strong style, comedy, fast pace, you know what I mean? Like, you find a click to what the crowd are interested in. You know what I mean? So, like, the past 5 years, that's what I've started. That's what I've been educated on. And that's what I'm gaining the experience, is trying to feel a crowd. You know what I mean? And work with a crowd to make them feel like they're part of the show. Because I strongly believe that is our job as a wrestler, is to make the fans come along, enjoy themselves, and want to see you when you come back the next time.
That's it. The balance has always got to be there. I mean, I know you've wrestled a couple of times in Elgin, where I've come to the shows there, because that's my it's my hometown. It's where I live. I don't want to say it's my hometown. People start believing that I'm born here. But yeah, so you've come to Elgin a few times. A lot of the crowd, I find, it's kids and it's adults who don't watch wrestling. So you guys, I mean, generally WTL have got a very good team that are able to do that. They've got Luke King Sharp, and who was able to do anything with a crowd he damn well pleases, and yourself as well. But yeah, it's always that kind of balance act that you've got to do. But back to WAW, you said that's when you're brought in, and that's when you learned after, was that 9, 10 years in the wrestling, you started learning more.
9 years.
What was it about WAW that made you think, right, this is the place I need to be? This is where I'm going to hold my craft.
Well, so I first met the Knights in, I believe it was the end of 2005, when they came up to Scotland to wrestle for W3L. And right away, it was Zach was the first one. Zach Zodiac was the first one that I'd met. And Zach basically took me under his wing as his sort of a protege. Anytime Zach was up here, Zach was always teaching me something. He was taking me in the ring. He was always looking after me. And then, after several years, the Knights stopped coming up to Scotland. So it got to around about 2013, I believe. And I was invited to travel with a group of guys to come down to Norwich for a weekend of training. And I thought, why not? Let's. What harm can it do? So that was in October 2013. So I came down here and I spent the weekend here. And just looking at the facility that they had, obviously now they actually have their own facility. I'm actually here in their facility right now in the backstage area. But before that, they were renting out a council hall. You know what I mean? So they were doing their training on Saturday morning, a Sunday morning, and then you had the Sunday show at night. So I came down and just seeing the different aspect of what wrestling could be compared to what it is in Scotland, because I found that in Scotland, there was a lot of cliques. You know what I mean? You scratch my back, I scratch yours, all that sort of thing. And I was never one for being a part of cliques. I tried to fit in, but I soon realised that's not for me. I just concentrate on yourself. I wish I took that advice when I was younger, not now, because God knows where we would be today. But thankfully, I got the time to take to educate and learn to be, obviously, the wrestler that I am today. But for WAW, they're unique. You know what I mean? They set the standards, but I believe, and anybody can argue against me if you want, but like, I'll just give you an example. WAW was the first ever promotion in Britain to be licensed to train children in professional wrestling. They got slagged, something rotten. Everybody was like bad mouthing them, saying, "Oh, it'll never work, you're exposing the business, blah 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 blah." How many promotions have you heard that have now got a kids' class all over Britain? Kids are training all over Britain. They also set the standards for people that were less abled. You know what I mean? Whether you had any sort of disability, you know what I mean? We've got a couple of lads here that have got Down syndrome. We've got about five or six lads that are autistic. But they go out there and they perform in that ring and they have a full-blown match. And you would never be able to, obviously you can, it's the things that you could tell that are obvious. But when they're in that ring, they're just like us. They're just like any other wrestler. So down here, it's more like a big family. They treat you different. You're not a workhorse machine, you know what I mean? Like, do this, do that sort of thing. You know what I mean? Everybody in this company has, they've got a place, they've got a position, and they've all got a certain value to them. And, like, just with the opportunities that I've been given through hard work, don't get me wrong, it's not just a case that, oh, Drew's here, give him that, or do that, do that. You know what I mean? I've been with WAW, it'll be 10 years this year that I've been with WAW. Sorry, 11 years this year that I've been with WAW. So, like, I've had to work up going through the academy all the way up through to then get to the main roster and build yourself up. So here, it's just different. It's so unique compared to anything else in Scotland. I've never seen, and I've yet to see anything like it in anywhere that I've travelled. So for me, it's just, it's home. I feel at home here.
I mean, you're talking about the all walks of life. I mean, I don't, I'll be honest, because we're Scottish wrestling based and I've got enough to think about and research it with that. I don't know an awful lot about WAW. That's my feeling there. Most of it is from things like Fighting With My Family, the documentary, and the movie as well. And it did show, I think it was Zach, training a blind wrestler.
James Chilvers, James is still part of us to this day. He still wrestles with us. He was in the ring with me yesterday doing some training. So he's still here to this day.
It shows that, like wrestling, if you want to do it, there is ways. There's some ways. I mean, we saw, what's his name? I've lost his surname. Gregory Irons. I was there. I was cerebral palsy, and so if you want to be a wrestler,
mate, look at Zach Gowen. Let's look at Zach Gowen. Mm-hmm. The man had one leg. He's a WWE superstar. He made it work. Absolutely. Anybody can make it work.
Speaking of Zach, as well, I think he's a hot topic in wrestling right now. Heading over to the US to wrestle in Ring of Honor, and by all sides of it, he's doing pretty well over in Ring of Honor. Is seeing your mentor being that successful, or at least on his way to being successful in the US, is that inspiration for yourself? Is that a goal for you as well?
100%. You know, like seeing where Zach started to where he got to where he is now. I don't think there's anybody in this planet that has ever put in the work and the dedication that man has done. You know what I mean? He's everybody knows the story. If you've seen the movie Fighting My Family, you know the story. You know what I mean? And now, no pun intended, but it's Zach's time. Zach is, hands down, he's going to take over America. Hands down. And honestly, I'm so proud. So, so proud to actually just even know the man. Do you know what I mean? To me, Zach, like my brother, you know what I mean? We're pretty close. But I don't believe anybody deserves this more than what Zach does, honest to God. Like, and he doesn't get the I understand he gets a lot of recognition, but he doesn't get enough recognition. Far from it.
He's definitely a guy that, again, you can model yourself on, maybe not model yourself on, but at least he's shown his failings. He's admitted himself what his failings are, but he still fought his way. I mean, some people may go nepotism, but if he's not good enough, then he's not going to keep coming back. He's not going to be Tony Khan's not going to keep bringing him back if he's not good enough to perform.
Exactly, and And I mean, for those of you that don't know, right now he's on a 3-0 winning streak in Ring of Honor TV. Come on, you make your debut and you're a 3-0. He's taking over America. Yeah, and I'm telling you right now, he's taking over America.
So speaking of taking over now, so we'll go back to our topic at hand, which is
yes,
WAW SA Wrestle Monster. Yes, it is.
Go. Wrestle Monster 6.
All over my brain here. So let's go back, see who past guests of that particular show have been. It's their biggest show of the year, by all accounts, yep, at Nelson Mandela Bay Splash Festival. Likes of the Wild Samoans, Rodus, yep, Clay, Joey Legend has been on, yep, those shows, PJ Black. So it's there's quite
Shelton Benjamin, Carlito, you know what I mean? You've got these guys as well.
And now WrestleMonster 6, it's the turn of WAW. So I think it's PJ Knight is one of the guys that are coming over. Yourself, Pete, as well.
So announced so far is myself and PJ Knight. And PJ is going to, he's going one-on-one against TJ Tremor for the WAW All-African title. So they traded that back and forth during the summer here in Norwich. And the return match is now going to be happening in South Africa.
So it must be wild for you. We've talked about how crazy it is you're going to be wrestling in South Africa. But I think out of all the guys in WAW that could have been chosen to be put forward to go to this, is there some sort of accomplishment after 19 years to go, I'm the top guy, the top three guys in this promotion that's why I've been sent to South Africa to be on the show, is just, yeah, that must be incredible to think of.
Of course, but, and I'm not just going to say this for the sake of the interview, I still don't believe I deserve it. For me, it's very surreal. You know what I mean? Like, I seen the post, like I got told about it a couple months back. I says I'll do it, that's fine. You know what I mean? And then, like, I just said to myself, let's see what happens. Let's see if it goes forward, or because you know, card subject to change and all that. Mm-hmm. And then the graphic went up 2 days ago, and that was when I could finally start talking about it and telling people. I'd be lying if I was to sit here and say that I did not burst into tears, because it's so surreal, should I say? You know what I mean? Like, I don't know what I've done to get to where I am. You know what I mean? And I just, the way I see it is, I've just been putting my head down, keeping my mouth shut, keeping my ears open, doing what I'm told, and then all of a sudden, I'm getting pitched for all these different ideas and all these different opportunities. So I'm sitting here like, wow. You know what I mean? Like I said yesterday to somebody that I've been in the business 19 years, and I've had so many setbacks, whether it be personal setbacks or just me no being a bit immature or naive or whatever when I was younger. So I've always found myself saying, oh, I wish this happened to me 10 years ago. I wish this happened to me 10 years ago. But see, if this, I now strongly believe, if this happened to me 10 years ago, would I be where I am today? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Would, like, because maybe I was too young. I'm only 31, so maybe being at such a young age and trying to accomplish this career, maybe, obviously, I'm the one for believing in fate or things like that, or, you know, like, well, we're here for a purpose. Maybe that's the purpose. Maybe I'm actually here to be a wrestler, but yet, as the story goes, you're just not ready for it yet. Get your foot in the door, get your experience, get your knowledge, and then when it's time, you'll know. And I believe now it's time.
I mean, times have changed, of course, when you're thinking, I mean, when you were 10 years ago, you'd be thinking, oh, if I'm getting these opportunities when I'm 30, that's too old. I'll be too worn down by that point. But we're finding nowadays with modern medicine and better conditions, yep, and training conditions, that 30 to 40 seems to be the prime years of life.
I've seen
all the guys like AJ Styles, who's moving into his mid-40s, and he's still, yep, at a top level of performer as well. It's a crazy thing to think about. And like you said, I mean, 10 years ago, wrestling landscape was totally different as well, not just for yourself, but for everyone. Because, I mean, that's when I must have been, how long have I been watching Scottish wrestling? So 2012. So I've seen a huge change in that time span between like you're saying, clicks. And this week especially, we've been seeing that kind of rear its ugly head again. But we've seen that kind of dissipate, and then some have come back. But it's a totally different world where opportunities are more fruitful. But yeah, there's still work to do. I think that's probably the best way to put
Course. Oh, aye, definitely, definitely. It's like everything else. Everything evolves. You know what I mean? So changes are going to happen.
it.
So, but I mean, like, as far as March 29th at the Nelson Mandela Bay, I mean, obviously we've just named off some of the former stars that were there. I mean, their top attendance, I believe, was 52,000 several years back for one of those shows. And then the expected attendance for March 29th was going to be 24,000. It's also being recorded for national theatre. Well, I say national TV, but it's South African TV. So there is a bit of exposure that's going to be there. But for me, this is probably the biggest opportunity that I've ever had in my career. And that also goes at like late last year. Like you said, I worked Scotty Too Hotty in the main event of WAW's version of WrestleMania. I worked Gangrel in December last year, and I'm now going over to South Africa. So, like, I mean, is this the start of something, or we don't know? Does that make sense?
Yeah, no pressure going in against one of the most popular, from what I've seen, one of the most popular wrestlers in South Africa, Mr. Wrestling.
Aye.
Against, I mean, just a few 24,000 people. What's the potential of more? Yeah, this is probably going to be one of the biggest nights of Irn Dru Marshall's career. Certainly,
Definitely,
by the sounds of it, because
definitely.
going in front of, well, maybe a handful of people. I'm sure you've had audiences, wrestlers in front of people that have. The wrestlers have outnumbered the crowd, and now you're going to be, I guess, be trying to
So,
entertain 24,000 people.
yeah, well, I'll be honest. I remember it was, I think it was 2010. I wrestled a show in Buckhaven Community Centre. There was six fans. That was it. One family sitting at one table, and you had like seven matches. Just one family paid for their ticket. You know what I mean? I mean, don't get me wrong. All the boys, we all got paid and whatnot. The promoter at the time, I don't, as far as I'm aware, he doesn't run shows anymore. I think it was maybe just a one-off.
Maybe that was the killer.
That was the killer. But aye, we all got paid, and like, I mean, I would assume you took a financial hit on that one, but like you say, it's a hit and a miss, isn't it? It's just wrestling for you.
Know, I'm sure someone else told me that story. So I think I know. I think I've spoken to someone else who's been on that show in the
Possibly.
past. Wow, that's just. I'm just imagining you guys just looking
Aye.
to. Imagine some people doing the old "come on, guys" and all that, and it's just six folks going.
Aye.
Or five, once went to the toilet, and there's going.
Well, it was an experience, so
You learn. That's it. It's all learning
course.
at the end of the day. I'll get out of my head now. Just coming out to see six. That's incredible. Right. So we did get a question through Instagram, which I will just bring up in front of me now. So, which is nice. It's a nice kind of roundup question, and then we'll do the big, nice last big push for the show.
Noise.
So it says he's worked for loads of promotions here in Scotland. Is there any that you want that he wants to be seen next in Scotland? So where do you want to wrestle?
Right. Well, I mean, let's just go back to what you were just saying. Like 10 years ago, the landscape of wrestling has changed. I think maybe we had like what, four or five maximum promotions in Scotland. Now you've got about 20, 25 promotions in Scotland. But like the companies that I've wrestled for in Scotland, I mean, like you've got W3L, you've got obviously Copenhagen Championship Wrestling based in Glasgow. I wrestled for PBW back in the day. Wrestled for I done one show for BCW. But like when you look at the caliber of shows, like there is a few promotions out there that I think to myself it'd be quite good to maybe go into their area. So like you've got for the likes of Discovery Wrestling in Edinburgh, that would be a big one. I see that recently they've just put up a picture to advertise their open weight title. So, I mean, can you imagine Irn Dru turning up at Discovery for a open weight title match? I think that would be quite cool. Or I suppose there's a tournament. Get my name in there. Let me show Discovery what I can do. Let me see if I can make Discovery that extra bit more exciting. You know what I mean? You've also got like, you've got Pro 2, which is based up in Ayrshire. Again, I think they've only been running for maybe 2 years, but they seem to be getting, like, they seem to be producing some good matches. They seem to be drawing in the crowds. So again, probably Pro 2 would be another company that I'd quite happily go work for. Off the top of my head, you've got your Fair City Wrestling based up in Perth. You've got SWE. I've been in talks with SWE for several years. Nothing's ever came to. But you never know, 2024 might be the year that you see Irn Dru up in Dundee wrestling. You know what I mean? So I'm an open book. You know what I mean? Like, obviously, if people want to see me, then make sure you're contacting your local wrestling promotions and get them told that you want to see me in action. Do you know what I mean? I'd probably just say I'd happily wrestle if it was obviously in the right situation and whatnot. I'd wrestle wherever people want me to wrestle. I'm not one of these guys that's going to sit here and say, I really want to work for this guy. I really want to work for that guy. I'm just happy to get the work. I'm happy to entertain the fans. And I'm happy if the promoter's happy with the matches. That's what you're there for. You're there to make sure, you know, that the production's going to move forward and that everybody's happy. So, if anybody in Scottish wrestling wants Irn Dru, you know where I'm at. I'm right here.
So a couple of the ones you mentioned as well, it's all about opportunity because, like, so Fair City, Pro 2, Discovery teased that they're going to have some online content. It's all about exposure as well. I mean, that's a nice added bonus, I suppose, if you're getting to do what you enjoy doing whenever you get to do it.
Exactly.
And it's online exposure, the right kind, not anything weird. You don't want to be exposing yourself online too much. So it's all good. So perfect. So before we go then, we'll do one final plug. For March 29th, you're facing the WAW SA champion, Mr. Wrestling, Nelson Mandela Bay, South Africa, at Splash Festival. If anyone is in South Africa and they haven't got a ticket yet, or they don't know, what would you tell them?
Aye. And to make things even better, your admission is free. There's no ticket prices.
Perfect. So, free wrestling, and you get to see Irn Dru, possibly the main event. Sounds like
exactly.
A main event. It's going to get Mr. Wrestling, anyone.
Fingers crossed.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much for joining me. For anyone who needs to know more about Irn Dru, what's your social media handles? Do you know them offhand?
So, Instagram is Scotty Superman. My Twitter is IrnDru92. And Facebook is Dru Marshall. You'll find me on all three social media platforms. TikTok is also IrnDru92. TikTok I don't really use as much as everybody else, but it's there.
Perfect. Well, again, thank you for taking the time to speak to me about this show. I'm looking forward to finding out more about it. It's a very, the African scene is always quite you don't know what's ever going to happen. I think that's probably the best way to do it. You don't know who's going to turn up and shows. So hopefully find out and what the result was, and we'll see some footage in the near future. But yeah, thanks for taking time to speak to me today.
Thanks for having me. It's a pleasure.